With us now on Live It Up is the dish on the chef, and her name is Marie. Hi, how are you?
Good. I'm good. How are you today?
Excellent. So you started out as a speech pathologist.
Yep.
And the career has now, somehow you're a journalist. So tell us about the journey.
Okay. I was always a journalist.
Okay.
Even as a speech pathologist. I wrote for the newsletters. I always did writing, whatever, and that's what I originally wanted to be. But I spent a career, a very good career as a speech pathologist, and I got a retirement, which is nice. So now I could do this. And the last 12 years or so, I found myself in restaurants a lot. I started this out, there was a program called Let's Do Brunch at the Home of a Friend. It was to support St. Charles Hospice, to build St. Charles Hospice. And every year there would be 15 homes, and mine was one of them. And I asked the chef from Bliss Restaurant in Setauket, Danny Avalos, if he would volunteer to work it. And it was, he makes this amazing banana French toast.
Mm.
People loved it and whatever. And they asked me to write a small article about the event. It was Eric Lamondo from Kitchen and Bistro, which now has closed and he's out at Orto. It was Joe DiNicola of Ruvo's, Tavola, and Del Fuego. And Danny Avalos of Bliss. So I wrote this little article, and that was kind of the trigger.
Okay.
And then I met Don Pintabona. Don Pintabona was the first executive chef at Tribeca Grill with Robert De Niro. And he's a celebrity chef, and he's a friend of mine. And he inspired me to get into this, to do this, because it wasn't about the food.
No.
It was more about the chef and why does he do this job that is so difficult in this hot weather. You never cool down a kitchen, you know, but they love it. I asked someone, if you won the lottery, what would you do, a chef? And he said, I'd open a restaurant. I said, are you crazy? No, he would open a restaurant because they love what they do.
It's become more and more competitive. I would say in the last 20 years, you know, being a chef, when you say celebrity chef, yeah, being a chef is like professional ball. I mean, you're constantly increasing your skill set. You're constantly, practicing it. Hours, like you said, hours and hours and hours just to come up with that recipe for success. You know, no pun intended, but that's pretty funny, recipe for success. What I find so fascinating is that you're right. They're so passionate about the craft. You know, people don't understand that. When they go to a restaurant and there's actually a chef, right, they're not understanding that that is that person's art.
Right.
They're creating art from what
and
it is.
And their home life is tough because they're never there for birthdays. They're never there for holidays. Forget it. You know, it's very hard to keep those two things going. I wrote an article for Luxury Living magazine, which is a Newsday publication.
Mm-hmm.
It has now turned into Long Island Living. And I picked five chefs from Garden City to Sag Harbor. And I asked them for their comfort food. Not what they serve in the restaurant.
Uh-huh.
But what did your family make for you? And I got some wonderful recipes. And then I looked at the articles. I'm writing it, and every chef was from a different country.
Oh, nice. Very international flavor to your...
Right. And I didn't realize it was doing that. So I had Ari Nieman from Garden City Hotel, who's from Finland. So he had an inspiration from his family.
Okay.
Matt Connors was an American from Bayshore. You know, that was the only one. There was Francesco Samoa from Gemma, which is now closed. It was in Huntington. He was from Brazil.
Mm-hmm.
And Chef Marco Pellegrini from Umbria in Italy. They brought him here. He worked in a restaurant that was at a resort, $40,000 a week to stay there. You get your own private chef.
My goodness.
But somebody went and got him and brought him here, and he's a wonderful, authentic Italian restaurant in Southold.
Oh, that sounds delicious.
And he just opened one this summer in Shelter Island. So he was from Umbria, and then my friend, Philippe Corbet, is at Lulu's in Sag Harbor. And he's from Chambray.
Now that people know you and they've kind of aligned you with different chefs and different restaurants, when you go to dine somewhere, Marie, is there like that feeling, or is there goodness, Marie's here, you know, it's the dish on the chef, you know?
I'm not Yelp.
Okay. And there's a big difference.
There's a big difference. Everything I do is positive.
Wonderful.
If I don't like you, I don't even mention it. You know, if I don't like your food, and with me, I'm allergic to a lot of things, so I'm not a very big gourmand, that kind of thing, you know. But I do like places. I know a lot of musicians because they play in restaurants, you know. And so this is funny. I recommend mixologists to Nico Chromidos,
okay,
who writes for Edible and wrote for Pulse.
Mm-hmm.
And my friend Tom Crawford is a mixologist. He was mixologist of the month in Pulse magazine when I was writing for them. He said, what do you know about cocktails? You don't drink anything. You drink a Chardonnay, a Prosecco maybe, you know? I said, yeah, but I know people.
Yeah.
And I have recommended 5 mixologists to Nico, who writes for all this stuff. So it's funny. So I don't have to drink the cocktails.
Now, somebody can go to your website and still see some of the articles that you've written.
Yes, and I update every day.
Wonderful.
The only thing that I wanted to point out, there's some new restaurants opening now.
Okay.
Kingfish Bar, Oyster Bar, is Tom Shodell.
Love him.
Just opened in the Vanderbilt in Westbury, just recently. There's a Pietra Italian restaurant opening in St. James, an Italian restaurant. I got that in from Guy Rouge, who's a 5-star chef at Mirabelle. The Kashi in Shelter Island is opening up. But I find that people, and then I'm sure you do, where do you live?
Where do I live?
Yeah.
I can't tell because then I'll have stalkers.
Are you NASA or something?
I'm on the border.
You're on the border.
I was just joking.
I find that people dine where they live.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I'm very lucky because I'm in Stony Brook.
Right.
And I've got pentimento, which makes an amazing zucchini flour stuffed with ricotta. I don't know if you've ever had that.
I have. When I went to Italy, I painted for 16 days, the very first time I ever had that.
Really?
Yeah, Casale Sannino. And we stayed there, and it was absolutely delicious. So where did you say that was?
Pentimentos makes one.
I'm going.
And Tutto Pazzo does one too.
Okay.
But I have never been.
It has
there.
To be seasonal though. I understand
oh,
that. But
yeah.
I'm like.
You know what's. Talk about me.
Yeah.
They call me when they're going to have it.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Could you call me
I'll
next?
I'll call you.
Like, Donna, it's Marie.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, hello, zucchini flowers.
So I go to Pentimento, and Bliss is a favorite of mine, and Chef Danny Avalos is there, and he makes, if you want to eat light,
yes,
a Thai salmon with slivered vegetables. No starch on the plate, but delicious.
Marie, I'm hungry now. Can
and
we
the
go?
Other thing
like,
is burrata.
Let's go.
Burrata. I don't know if you like
yeah.
I said I'm doing a research study.
Okay.
On burratas. So wherever there's a good burrata, I'll be there.
Then you're there
I'll
to go.
Be there. Yeah, yeah.
I can't wait. Let's go dine together.
Yes,
thank
we should
you
do
very
that.
Much. I see you at so many events, and like I said, in the green room, I want to thank you because you've been such a strong, ardent supporter of me all these years. And when I'm posting things, you'll share it, or if I tell a funny story, you share it. And
yes.
I just wanted to tell you thank you for
oh,
that.
I
so
love
I wanted
that.
To kind of have you,
you
on and to reverse the opportunity to shine a light on you.
Thank
so,
you.
But thank you very
thank
much
you.
For joining us. And we're going to look for all these great chefs.
And the biggest thing about my blog is when somebody comes up to me, I don't know, and says, I'm here because of you.
Oh, voila.
You know, I'm dining here for the first time because you told me to. So that makes it nice.
Absolutely.
All right.
She knows her stuff. Grab a fork, a knife, a spoon, head out with Marie to the next restaurant. Thanks for watching Live It Up.